for his remarkable contribution of 59 years to the upstream oil and gas industry in India. We thank ladies and gentlemen who contribute to the industry even at the age of 78 years. Third suspension. Record of 48 years in the E&P industry of India, especially for his role in finding and developing hydrocarbon assets overseas for India as Managing Director of ONGC Videsh from 1994 to 2004.
Excellencies, dignitaries from the global and Indian hydrocarbons, dear politicians, ladies and gentlemen. I am honored to receive this prestigious award from Honorable Governor Sri Ram Naik. I am thankful for the presence of Honorable Minister Sri Dharmendra Ji. And I humbly accept this award. I started as a lieutenant in 1959 in the OGC and retired after more than 41 years service in OGC as a captain. Maybe one of the longest service done in the OGC. Presently with this board, and encouragement from Sri Rishmar, Chairman, Panelist Offshore. I am working and continuing to add value to the offshore industry after my supervision. I am honored to see this and I reaffirm that I will continue to work for this oil sector. And this tested to the safe working on the drilling rigs, environment friendly, and the people working on the rigs or the operations area are harmless.
National Gas Corporation, Sri Shashi Shankarji, ministers from overseas, excellencies, ambassadors and high commissioners, representatives of oil and gas sector world over, various awardees, Chairman Steering Committee, invited speakers and delegates, friends from media, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. At the outset, I wish to congratulate the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas for hosting the 13th edition of Petrotech 2019 successfully here in my state, that is Uttar Pradesh. I am happy to be here in the valedictory session amidst the best minds from the oil and gas industry today. Petrotech is now well established after the series of 13 successful events organized since 1995 and has secured a reputation in international circles as one of the most respected fora in the global hydrocarbon industry. The theme of this Petrotech 2019, Shaping the New Energy World Through Innovation and Collaboration, there could not have been a more apt theme than this today, when the global oil and gas sector is facing disruptions from renewables, electricity, mobility, etc. This is in line with the approach of Government of India, which has launched various schemes over the past 4 years to promote innovation through a culture of entrepreneurship and startups in the country. I compliment my younger colleague, Sri Dharmendra Pradhan, who should soon be completing a full 5 years term as a Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas. Energetic and restless is he who is for improving the lot of vast majority of fellow countrymen at an unmatched pace. He has several accomplishments to his credit in serving the cause of the have-nots and economically weaker sections of our society, providing access to clean energy at their doorsteps has been a dream realized. Having mentioned his nearly 5 years in the petroleum ministry, I feel nostalgic to recall my own full term as a Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas under the astute leadership of our most respected and beloved Prime Minister, late Atal Bihari Vajpayee. That was the first time in India's history when anyone led the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas for a full term of 5 years since 1962. Younger generation, I must explain to you that Petroleum Minister was knocked out separately. Earlier it was part of Chemicals, Fertilizers and Petroleum. So in 1962, separate Petroleum Ministry was formed, and I was the only lucky person to lead the Petroleum Ministry for 5 years. Earlier ministers could have sometimes 1 year, 2 year, 3 years, all the numericals, but less than four. So that was my luck. And the same luck is being repeated by Sri Pradhan, and I congratulate him for the work he has been doing in the last 4.5 years. Rapid reforms was the mantra then, and the country achieved unmatched rate of growth. Not only was untripped supply of clean and improved quality of petroleum products across the length and breadth of the country achieved, then a bolster of energy security of our country, but the India Hydrocarbon Vision 2025 was presented at that time. Strategic crude oil storage projects launched, besides ethanol blending of petrol and foray into biodiesel and hydrogen as fuel. Several of these have fructified. Knowledgeable journalists called it as a golden era in the Indian petroleum history of that period.